Yep. All right, so I guess I'm gonna thank you all for coming. My name is Ty Clarkson, and what I did for my petition is a global citizen, and here's some of the reasons why I chose global citizen. So for like the past 3 months, I have a friend, and his name's Kyle, and he's been homeless. And since he's my friend, I felt the need to like help him like achieve getting out of his car and stop living in his car and stop having to scrape up change just to get a little bit of food. So like I helped him like try and get a job, and I tried to talk him into going to trade school and stuff like that, but he don't feel like that's really necessary. He feels like high school diploma is all he needs. So for like, I'm kind of like go off topic. So like for the last 3 days, I went through a lot of thinking and stuff like that, and I met somebody named Justin, and basically like I really felt like I didn't have a purpose. Like all I wanted to do after high school was get a job at a factory, honestly, smoke weed and just hang out with my friends. That's not really like giving myself a purpose, because every person has a purpose, you know what I'm saying, in life. So like we really sat down and we really talked about like what I want to do after high school and stuff like that, and he really made me realize, I might as well just pass this out now. Pass it off for me. Here, I'll give one to Mr. Robinson. He really made me realize what I want to do with my life and stuff, and I plan to start like a nonprofit organization called Ty's Chance, and basically what I want to do is like I wanna help people understand what they want to do with themselves whenever they get out of high school, or if they already are out of high school, if they're old, and they don't really understand what they want to do with themselves. Or they do, they just don't know how to take that and like run with it. So like what I wanna do is I'm gonna start a nonprofit organization where I'm gonna get homeless people off the streets and like put them in like basically like little college dorm, if I can ever like get enough money, save up enough money, do fundraisers to like get a building so I can like make little college dorms so they can like sleep there. Basically what I was thinking was like the first month or so I'm gonna really teach them how to like dress properly and stuff like that, give them a haircut and stuff like that. And teach them how to dress appropriately in certain places. So, yeah, that's what I want to do with that. My cultural understanding is I'm mixed, so like I have a cultural understanding of like my background and what my family believes in. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, go ahead. I participated in the school election for the president. I haven't really done any like clubs. Yeah, there you go. I haven't done any clubs. I really never fit in with that type of thing. So yeah. Go ahead. My civic duty. To be honest, I don't really feel like the president is necessary. But I believe that, I don't think Donald Trump is a very good president. I don't believe in the things that he says and does. So being like with the whole hooker situation or whatever that is, I don't really believe in all that. I think that's wrong. But I did register to elect for the president about 2 weeks ago. So yeah, you can go ahead. Sports. I played basketball in my old school. I played baseball, but sports was never really my thing. But apparently, my little brother, he really likes basketball, and he's on a travel team. And he's 8 years old, and he only got picked out of 60 people. So like, I wanna help him do better with that. I just never really been good with sports, so I don't really understand how to help him. But let me try.
trying to like figure that out as the days go by.
Go ahead.
Yeah, and like I said at first, I probably should talk about this at the end, but like with Taj Chinch, like someone really believes in me and wants to see me do good. So he's gonna help me build this program and help me like prosper with it, because he knows a little bit more about business than I do. So basically, I have a job where I'm getting paid to make a business for myself. So it's not even like I'm out here grinding by myself. I don't have anything. I'm down bad. No, like someone has came in my life, told me, look, I'm going to help you make this happen. And I'm also going to pay you as you're researching it, looking up how to fundraise. I'm going to pay you. So, yeah. This was like a overnight type thing. Like, it was like we sat down at dinner and like he was like, what is your purpose? Because every person has a purpose. And he really helped me understand that, like, working at a factory, hanging out with your friends, smoking weed is not a purpose. It's just like, it's living without a purpose, and that's kind of like a scary feeling, you know what I'm saying? So he really helped me realize what I want to do with my life. So, yeah.
Pretty much done.
Any questions, Q&A type situation?
You come back and get on your petition a little bit.
Yeah.
Maybe talk about your kind of your academic pathway, what has led you here today, and
The reason that I'm petitioning to graduate is because I didn't understand my purpose. I didn't understand what I wanted to do with myself. So that's why whenever I did exhibitions and so forth and so on, it wasn't very good, because I didn't really understand what I wanted to do with myself after high school. So now I'm standing here today so I can let you know what I want to do. Like, academically, I wasn't the best in school, you know what I'm saying? So, I don't know, I always passed by, like, barely, stuff like that. But, things that I said in my petition have nothing to do with what I'm standing here telling you right now. So for me to explain it to you would be lying.
Can you talk about like your academic interventions? So you talked about how some of you are trying to be engaged in those kind of things. What kind of supports did you have throughout your high school career? Who helped you along the way? What do these people mean to you?
Through middle school, the person that really helped me the most was this lady named Ms. Conneron. And I haven't talked to her in, I don't know, it's probably been a year. But yeah, she really, 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 really helped me out, like, through my middle school and partially my high school career. So, but Miss Long probably was the main person to really help me through my junior and senior year, you know what I'm saying? So, she really helped me more than I've ever needed help for, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah.
You were here for our first year, Big Picture, in our founding year. So what do you think this 2 years, like this experience, what has this meant to you?
It taught me a lot, you know, with like not understanding why I was doing the exhibition and stuff like that. And now I realize like why we do this, and it's because like I said, it's to help you find your purpose in life, like why you are here today, you know what I'm saying? Like, you are not here today for no reason, like, yeah. So like the whole exhibition thing, I think is like the most important part about this school, because it really like lets you know what you want to do, even if you don't at the end, like, you know what I'm saying?
Is there anything that you there any advice that you could give to maybe a new freshman coming in?
If you're like me, keep your eyes open and listen. Like, you don't really got to say much, just listen and keep your eyes open, because what y'all are trying to teach us, I didn't understand, you know what I'm saying? Because I would come and y'all would want me to do my exhibition, and I'd be like, no, you can get out of my face. That was how I felt at first. But now that I really sit back and like look at the big picture, it's like, all you're trying to do is help me. So, yeah, I didn't really understand that, so now I understand that. Is there anything else? Questions?
What's the next step for Ty's chance?
Sit down and talk about how, like, I'm going to fundraise. Because I want to do a nonprofit organization. Like, I want to be more personal than, because, like, I understand that, like, with, like, a homeless shelter, they understand that, like, you're helping them and, like, you're giving them a place to stay, food, water, you know what I'm saying, a bed. They understand that, but, like, I'm trying to get more personal. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to, like, just like with my friend Kyle, like, that's my friend, so I feel like I needed to help you, you know what I'm saying? So, like, if I'm just gonna make it a homeless shelter, I'm just gonna be like, here you go, here's your stuff, period. I want it to be like, let's sit down, let's talk, why are you homeless? What made you homeless? How can we help you get out of this situation? Do you even want me to help you get out of this situation? Are you gonna work with me? Like, you know what I'm saying? Because a homeless shelter is just, here you go. That's it. I'm like, here you go. Plus, let me talk to you about what happened and how we can fix that. So, any questions?
I think that you now realizing that you have to have a purpose in life is going to hopefully drive and give you something to look forward to.
Yeah.
I think that your mom being a member of our community, she's aware of the Open Door of Hope and Awake Ministries, and I think that we can all help you make contact with those people, because Open Door of Hope is a community program in our city right now that it would be beneficial for you to go and speak with those people that run that program, because you do have to have a purpose in life. You have to have. Because we want to see you be successful, and there's been moments here at Big Picture where you've been very successful, but then also your attitude has driven some of the downfalls. But like today, when you have to rise to the occasion, somewhere you reach down in there and find it.
Yeah.
So, you know, you're going to be a graduate of Big Picture Learning Academy and Shelby County Public Schools, and it is your job to go out there and represent your diploma. That, I mean, you're going to be a graduate, so we want you to be successful out there. We want to see what you have going on in your future and what abilities you have. There's going to be people that are going to be counting on you.
Yeah.
Because if you're going to do something like that, those people might not have that purpose that you have now. So you could help motivate them to find that purpose.
Yeah. Any more questions?
I do think you got speaking from passion, and I hope you took the first steps, and I hope you continue to go with that and truly see this as your purpose and passion.
Yeah.
And go with it. So, I wish you luck in that. Mm-hmm. Like Ms. Long says, that when it comes down to nitty gritty, you step up to the occasion. Like I've seen you present before and present very well. Mm-hmm. So I encourage you to use those skills and presentation ability to help make this a reality.
Yeah, sure.
And looking at your pieces, because I see your letter, your plans after high school, and your resume, I would just take your resume and just take that a little bit more in depth. So I would just grow in that, especially with your experience at McKinley's. You know, just get in there, and like right now it just says you were there for 9 weeks, and it's a restaurant, of course, but like, what are some of the things that, you know, I know I worked with you personally on learning the menu and the things that were required to make a certain sandwich. So, I mean, just being more specific as to what your jobs were there, I would just clean up your resume a little bit more, because, I mean, you're going to need a resume.
Yeah.
Now that you're going to be looking for work, they're going to be asking for resumes. Okay.